Princess? I have no idea. Why on earth would you want to keep that from me?
She didn't tell anybody. God, she must have been going through hell. When I think of that animal, that bastard deserved to die.
Well, it'll certainly make a difference to her defense. We've definitely got a case for justifiable homicide now.
I just wish it was that simple.
She will testify in court, won't she? I know it'll be unpleasant, but, well, it's her only chance.
She's not worried about herself, but she won't hear of Emma having to go through it too.
Oh, can't do much without Emma's supporting evidence.
I know, but she'd rather deny it all than make her sister suffer anymore.
Well, I can understand that.
Listen, love. I'm sorry about last night. I had a few too many to drink and started feeling sorry for myself.
Look, Kevin, I've got to get to my cleaning job.
Cheryl, please, I want to try again.
No, Kevin. It's always going to be the same.
You're carrying my baby. Doesn't it mean anything to you? It's worth another shot, isn't it?
Are you trying to blackmail me?
Oh, I wouldn't call it that. More like wanting a few reminders.
Such as?
Some booze and cigarettes.
Forget it.
All right. Auntie Joan. Told you I had a terrible memory.
All right. I'll see what I can get. But that's it.
You're so good to me, Miss Ferguson.
I don't know, but it must be pretty good to get you moving at that rate of knots.
Get ready for it. The freak's got a new girlfriend.
Oh, what?
You're joking. Who take up with her?
The new girl, Lucy Walker.
Oh, come off it, love. She'd be in the joint 5 minutes.
That'd make her a bit quick off the mark, wouldn't it?
Sure does, because I caught him having a quick cuddle in the corridor.
You must be imagining things. No one would milk Ferguson's ice that fast.
I'll give a 0 out of 10 for taste.
Maybe they knew each other before.
Yeah, maybe Maxine's imagination's had their little field day. What do you say, Maxine?
I say you can take it or leave it. I'm just telling you what I saw.
Well, you might have made a mistake, Maxie. I reckon Fergo bailed the poor kid up. You know what she's like.
Oh, come off it. It wasn't Fergo doing the cuddling, it was Lucy. The freak looked like she was going to burst a blood vessel.
The little tart. And you wouldn't have thought butter would have melted in the mouth.
Yeah. Gonna have to keep an eye on that young lady.
You feeling better?
Yeah, a bit. Nothing like a good cry, huh?
Yeah.
Nerve of that bastard. Fancy him hanging around here like that. I'll tell you one thing. He turns up here again, I'm gonna wipe the wall with his face.
He is still my husband, Jude. And he does love me.
Well, then he should act more responsibly. Cheryl, you're not thinking of going back to him, are you?
No, I told him I wasn't. I did try real hard. I wanted it to work.
I know you did, honey. But you've got to start thinking of yourself now and that baby. She's important too, you know.
Yeah, I know. It's just that... Well, when people fight, I mean... There are always faults on both sides, aren't there?
There is no way that you can justify him hitting you.
Maybe not, but... Well, I have been real moody with Kev, especially since I got pregnant. Things sort of upset me easily, and...
That is only natural. He should have been supportive. God, you're not going to fall for that old thing, are you?
What?
Blaming yourself. I've seen it happen many times. A woman gets raped and suddenly she thinks, oh, it must be my fault. I must have let him on. Hasn't even met the guy. And the same goes for battered wives. Now, that is Kevin's weakness, Cheryl, not yours.
I suppose you're right.
Of course I'm right. You let us sort out what's best for you and the baby. And you stop worrying, okay?
Right, this afternoon we're going to talk about the Great Depression.
Look at there!
Can't we learn about something more up to date?
Most of us weren't even born then, except the ones with the wrinkles, of course.
Shut up, you rude bugger!
If you paid more attention to your history instead of sitting there and picking your nose.
Oh, Lizzie, come on.
Well, they were very interesting times.
Depressing, more like. Come on, fun time's over. Let's get back to work.
You could tell us what it was really like, couldn't you, Lizzie?
You bet I could. Well, I suppose it's more or less like it is today. You know, all those young couples with kids and breadlines. We used to have to make soup from the smell of an oil rag.
Yeah, well, I reckon Mrs. O'Regan knows all about that, only she leaves the rag in there.
Like it, right? Hey! Hear that racket halfway down the corridor.
We've just started our lesson, Miss Ferguson.
Yeah, sounded more like a riot to me.
Oh, come on, we weren't making that much noise.
No, we were just discussing the depression, Miss Ferguson.
Shut up, Birdsworth. School is over.
Oh, we're allowed to have this class, and that's what we're going to do.
Oh, no, you're not, Smith. You are now on a charge for insubordination. Back to your cells, the lot of you. Come on, move it, or you'll all be on a charge. Come on. I'll be making a report to the governor about this, Roberts. I don't think your classes are going to last much longer. Pity.
She had no reason to do that.
Since when has she ever needed a reason?
Bloody rat bag.
Do you think Mrs. Reynolds will stop the classes?
Over my dead body. Ferguson's not going to screw this one up for us. Speaking of which, it's about time I had a word with this one. Tell her who her best friend is around here. Well, well, if it isn't little Lucy Walker. I hear you've got a protector.
What? Don't know what you're talking about.
The freak. You were seen having a very intimate little tete-a-tete with her in the corridor.
Oh, that.
Oh, that. Let me give you a word of advice. No one gets that close to Ferguson. Not unless they're as corrupt and double-dealing as she is.
She's the kiss of death. You better keep well away from her.
Look, she seems to like me for some reason. What's wrong with that? We can use it.
Oh, yeah? How?
Well, she'll do whatever I want. Bring in stuff for us. Booze, extra cigarettes, that sort of thing.
Hey, that's not a bad idea. Do you reckon you could swing it, Lucy?
You deal with her and you'll deal with me, and don't you forget it.
But if we're just using her, what's wrong with that?
No one deals with the freak. Two very good reasons. Firstly, she's the user. And secondly, because I say so.
Come on, Emma. At least eat your eggs.
Sorry, Auntie. I'm just not hungry.
We don't want Dr. Collins to think you're wasting away, do we?
What's it got to do with him?
Well, he's coming here to see you this evening. He rang last night. Nice of him to think of us, wasn't it?
But why does he want to see me?
Oh, well, you are Petra's sister, dear. Of course he wants to know how you are. And I think he wants to give you a bit of a check-up too while he's here.
No! I'm sick of having check-ups. There's nothing wrong with me. I wish you'd just...
Oh, it can't do any harm. Now, don't be so silly. It's very kind of him to worry about you like this. Especially when he's got so much on his mind with Petra. Not knowing what's going to happen to him.
Maybe nothing will happen to her.
I think we have to accept that she won't be coming home for a very long time.
But she hasn't had her trial yet. They might let her off.
Don't think so.
Maybe she didn't kill Daddy.
What do you mean?
Well, nobody saw her. Could have been a burglar or something.
Emma, please. You know that's not very likely.
But it could have happened like that.
Who'd be so wicked to let somebody else take the blame for such a dreadful crime? Besides, Petra's already told the police she did it. I know it's hard for you, dear. But you must remember, whatever Petra's reasons for doing such an awful thing, she still loves you very much. She won't want you to feel hurt and unhappy. Now, come on. You'll be late.
Thanks. They'll come in real handy.
Enjoy them. They're the last you're getting from me.
Oh, no, Auntie. I've just finished making a nice long list of all the things I need.
Forget it. The game's over.
It's only just beginning. The other women think I'm on with you. I need protection.
Then buy it somewhere else. I'm not risking my job for you.
You're risking it already. There's dope hidden at your place.
You're bluffing.
No, I'm not. I left it as a going away present.
I don't believe you. You'd have taken it with you.
Why should I bother? I can get into your house any time I like. I'm pretty good at picking locks. Can you think of a better place to hide dope than in a screw's house?
All right. Where did you hide it? I'm warning you. Tell me where you hid it.
Touch me and I'll go straight to the governor. I'll tell her you hid the dope and bash me to keep me quiet.
You conniving little bitch!
So I think you better do what I say, don't you, Auntie?
Well, we're hobbling off to the market. You want to come? Fresh air will do you good.
No, thanks, Jude. I'd rather stay here. Got a lot of thinking to do.
Okay. Well, Wally's in the other room if you need anything.
Hey, if you're going to be sitting around, could you look after Lisa for me? She won't be no trouble. Give me a bit of a breather, that's all.
Yeah, of course.
You behave yourself now.
You sure you're going to be all right?
Yeah.
Well, I got to go to court this morning as well, but Bob will bring back the groceries. See you about lunchtime, huh?
Bye, Lisa.
Bye, honey.
Bye, Mum.
Why are you staying here? Me and Mummy had to come because Daddy hit us all the time. Did you get hit all the time too?
No.
Daddy used to yell at us when he got mad. He broke Mum's arm once.
Well, all daddies aren't like that, love. It's only if they got worries. Your dad was good too, wasn't he?
Yes, sometimes.
Kev's real good to me. He only hit me once and that's because he's worrying about me and the baby. I don't deserve someone as good as him.
Oh, Mrs. Reynolds, I've got Smith outside.
Good, show her in.
Sure.
Oh, Mrs. Barry?
Yeah.
It's Sharon Smart's trial today. Do you know whether Miss Ferguson's arranged for transportation?
Oh, I'm not sure. She's gone off for an hour or so. I think something urgent cropped up at home.
Oh, well, would you check that after I finish talking to Smith?
Yes, certainly. Come on.
Mrs. Reynolds, this is about what happened in the recreation room last night.
No, it's not. We'll talk about that later. Sit down.
Why, what's happened?
Apparently, you and Lizzie were very friendly with an ex-prisoner, Jeannie Brooks. Mum, I think you called her.
Yeah, that's right. What about her?
I've got some rather sad news for you. She died last week.
Sorry. Oh, God, Mrs. Barry. I've been waiting so long that I thought I should have brought some rations with me.
With the breakfast you packed away, Lizzie, there's no worries about you starving to death.
Don't you bet on it. Good love, Mrs. Reynolds must have laid into you. You look as though you lost one of your best friends.
I did. We all did. Mum Brooks died.
Oh, babe. Good old Mum. She didn't suffer, did she?
No, died in her sleep.
Oh, that's the way all the good ones should go. No pain. I need a few more people like her in here. Do you remember how she used to take all the young ones under her wing when they first came in?
Yeah. The only mum some of them ever had. She's more than that, though. And the risk she took when I was wandering around not knowing which end was up. She almost ended up back in here for helping an escaped con.
Yeah, well, thank God she didn't come back and die in this dump. At least she had a few good years out there.
And she never forgot us. And that's what Reno wanted to see me about. Come on, concerns everybody.
Oh, you can tell me. Is a granddaughter going to get married?
sounds like she was a really nice lady.
She was. They don't make many of them like Mum anymore. Wish we could have gone to them. Hey, Bea, can we get to go to the funeral?
No, love, they've already had the funeral. But she never forgot her mates on the inside. She's remembered us in her will.
She left us some money.
Oh, now you're talking, how much?
Don't know you.
What's it matter? Be really nice to have a little something to remember about.
Yeah, well, I got the impression it wasn't exactly peanuts. More like a couple of thousand.
Oh, even better.
What'd she do, rob a bank?
Of course she didn't. Mum wasn't like that. Was she, Bea?
No. Anyway, you know as much about it as I do. Now, come on, smoke goes over.
We'll be able to get a new TV for the rec room. Save all the fights about what we're going to watch.
Better off with a stereo and lots of records.
We'll get both.
Cut it out, you two money grabbers. Mum isn't cold in a grave yet and you're spending her money already.
I thought that was the idea. She left it to us, didn't she?
That's right.
Hey, maybe we could split it all up and then we could do what we like with it.
Yeah, and I could get some...
Will you shut up, a lot of you? Mum didn't leave us that money to spend it on biking magazines and pop records. It's to be used for the good of everyone. Now, just cut the crap or I'll tell them that they can keep it.
More likely going into the Queen Bee Retirement Fund. Come on, Ruth.
And where are you two going?
Dunny.
Bloody selfish buggers.
What do you want?
Not bad, eh? Nothing but the best.
Hey, what if you like?
Thanks very much.
Hey, what are you doing?
Where'd you get them fags? You haven't been here long enough for buy-up.
I brought them in.
Bull! Had them brung in more like by your screw girlfriend, right?
Bea told me not to trade with her. You were there.
Don't all think like she does. I reckon you're onto a good lurk and we want in on it.
All right. Tell me what you want and I'll see what I can do.
I'm going to bring supplies in. Regular.
You can start by getting us some booze and smokes and nice soap and stuff.
I can't promise all that.
You'll promise it and deliver. Otherwise we'll mess your face up so much even the freak won't look at you.
Well, what do you say?
All right.
Good. I thought you'd see things our way. Now just don't take too long about it, that's all.
This deprogramming Sharon Smart was subjected to, you say you've been through it yourself?
Yes.
Then you'd know her state of mind at the time of the alleged stabbing?
She was very distressed.
And in your opinion, that was because of the deprogramming?
Yes. She'd been brainwashed, starved. She was completely disorientated.
You arrived on the scene directly after the stabbing. Is that right, Miss Bryant?
Yes, that's right.
Would you please tell the court Miss Smart's emotional state when you entered that room?
Well, she was upset, confused, hysterical.
Then she was not in complete control of the situation at all. She was, in fact, driven to a point of desperation.
You and two other parties
abducted your sister off the street. Is that correct?
I had to. It was a last resort. I was so worried about her.
She was, in fact, in that attic against her will?
Yes.
And that, plus the deprogramming, contributed to her state of mind?
Yes, she didn't know what she was doing.
The jury has found you guilty as charged, but I believe there are mitigating circumstances. I therefore sentence you to 3 years probation.
Those lazy buggers are taking long enough in the dunny. Getting out of work more like it.
Now, what's the matter with you? Good, you can be a grumble bum.
What do you mean, what's the matter with me? I've just lost one of my mates and all you're thinking about is money. I haven't forgotten what Mum's done for the likes of you.
Lizzie, there's a letter here for you.
Well, I don't know if I want it. The mail's too early. It must be bad news.
Oh, Mrs. Morris didn't seem to think so.
Well, maybe it's from Foxy. Be quick. Where are Miss Specs?
Come on. Open it up. What's it say?
Oh, he sent me a photo. It's Foxy.
My goodness, Lizzie, he's a pretty swanky-looking fella.
Mm. Yes, he looks very nice.
What's the matter? Why so down? I wouldn't be unhappy if a bloke like that was rotting to me.
God, he's gone all posh. He's even signed himself Michael J. Lawson.
Well, he's probably still the same bloke underneath. Now, come on, what does he say?
He says he got married in England and he's been living there for the past 30 years and that he's missing all his mates. And that he wants me to send a photo in me next letter.
Well, there you go, Lizzie. You finally got yourself a fella.
But I can't have me photo taken in this.
Well, you can always say you're the cleaner in Wentworth.
Maybe Mrs. Reynolds will let you wear something else for it.
No, Mrs. M will fix it for you. And I'll do your hair. When we finish with you, you look like Lady Birdsworth.
Yeah. I suppose so.
Ah, come on, grumble bum.
Hi. How'd the babysitting go?
Oh, fine. We had a great time. She's a great little kid.
Well, I wish I could say the same about my day.
Didn't your friend get off?
No. She daubed herself in to save her sister.
Oh.
And she has to face her own trial. Well, it's not that funny, you know.
Sorry, June. It's just that this is,
Cheryl?
Hmm?
Oh, my God. What have you been taking?
Nothing.
Don't give me that. You're as high as a kite.
Excuse me, the dogs.
Now, you get the hell out of here.
Cheryl.
Get away from me, Kevin.
Okay, honey.
You get away from me.
How many did you take?
Why don't you leave me alone? Just
Cheryl.
Leave me alone!
Cheryl!
Why don't you just get out of here, Kevin? Just get out! Ah!
Oh, my God. Cheryl.
I heard what happened. Everything all right?
We don't know yet. For God's sake, will you try and get him to sit down somewhere?
Come on, mate. Relax.
I can't. Not until I know if she's okay or not. If anything happened to her or the baby, I don't know what I'll do. They're all I've got.
I can't make you out. You really do love her, don't you?
Of course I do. We've known each other since we were kids. It was always just Cheryl and me.
So when did she start popping pills?
Way back, at school. First it was uppers and downers, that sort of thing. Just to help her cope with not doing well in class.
Then things got worse, huh?
When she couldn't get a job, she started on mandrakes. Then we got married. It was okay for a while. But I lost my job. She used to worry.
What's she on now?
Amphetamines. I didn't mind at first because it helped her get through the day. Then she got pregnant. I got scared, Jude. Scared that it'd harm the baby. We used to have some awful fights. I started drinking. But I only ever hit her once. And I've never forgiven myself. Now I want another chance. Sort out our hassles and be a family again.
Yeah, well, I know what we can do with the dough we're getting.
What's that?
Get rid of Mrs. O'Regan and get in a real cook.
There you talk.
Well, that sounds like a wonderful idea. How about a French chef? You know, nice young French chef.
Trust you to come up with something like that.
Well, I'll be back. Just get a look at her, will you?
Looks like Miss Walker has a very short memory.
Yeah, I could do with a drop of that myself, the lucky bugger.
She's not going to feel so lucky when I finish with her.
Reckon she got it from the freak.
Where else?
Lizzie, I've spoken to Mrs. Reynolds about your photo. She's given permission for you to have one taken.
Beauty! Oh, but I can't get taken in this, can I?
No, you can wear your own clothes.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. M. You are a good sort. Well, I've finished me tucker, so can we get on with it now? Hey, will you come and give us a bit of a brush up? I'll be waiting for you in me dorm. Just here it'd be all right, I reckon. Among the bushes. Makes it look like a real park or something. Was nice of the little receptionist to lend me a coat, wasn't it?
Yes. Do you think perhaps you could do up a couple of the buttons, Lizzie? It might make it look a little more snug.
Oh, righto, Mrs. M.
Oh, could you try and look a bit more natural, Lizzie?
Oh, God, it's hard, Mrs. M, in front of the camera. I don't know what to do with me hands. I know. You come have your photo taken with me, Mrs. Powell.
Oh, certainly not. Good idea. Might help Lizzie to relax. All right. Don't take all day, though. I'm on a break.
Oh.
What about the uniform?
I'll bite. What about it?
Good, yes. Mick and wonder what I was doing with a screw. Here, Mrs. Powell, you put this on.
Are you ready?
Far ahead, Mrs. M. God, that's really magic. Oh, isn't that nice? I'll tell Mick you're one of me mates from up the street, Mrs. Powell.
How is she, Doc? She all right?
She's fine, Mr. Armstrong. It's just general bruising and lacerations.
Thank God for that. I've never forgiven myself if she... What about the baby?
I'm sorry, Mr. Armstrong.
Doc?
She'd had a pretty bad fall. We tried. There just wasn't anything we could do.
Does Cheryl know about the baby?
I gotta see her. She'll need me.
Later. She's been given a sedative.
Nah. I gotta talk to her. She can't be alone at a time like this.
She has to be. She needs the rest. You can see her in an hour or so. Oh, there is one other thing, Mr. Armstrong. When we did blood tests on your wife, we found a high level of barbiturates and amphetamines. Can you explain that?
Oh, I think I can understand that, Doctor. Cheryl was pretty frightened. I think she probably took something to soothe the nerves, you know?
You ain't gonna report her, are you?
I have to.
Yes, Doctor, is that really necessary?
I'm afraid so. But I wouldn't worry. I doubt if she'll be formally charged.
Yeah, well, she better not be. Kevin, want me to hang around for a while?
Yeah.
Hello, Walker. I want a word with you. What were you lacing your coffee with?
Nothing.
Don't give me that. It's a bottle of booze. A little gift from your girlfriend, right?
No.
I thought I told you not to trade with her.
Well, I got it before you said that.
Well, I don't believe you. You're a slow learner, aren't you? Well, maybe this will make you understand more easily. And in case you didn't get the message in the first time, don't deal with the fake.
I couldn't help it. Ruth and Phyllis made me. They want stuff brought in.
I am top dog around here. You do as I say.
But they'll bash me if I don't get them what they want.
Oh, and I'll bash you if you do. You're doing badly, are you, Walker? Only been in here a few minutes and already you're the meat in the sandwich. Well, if I were you, I'd keep a very low profile in future. And for the last time, keep away from the freak!
Now that's the drug list. That's the laundry requirements and the general medical report on the women.
Good. Nothing seriously wrong with anyone, I hope.
Oh, no, not really. Although there are a couple of individual cases I'd like to talk to you about, if you have a moment.
Yes, of course, that's what I'm here for. Come in. Oh, thank you, Robert. Just leave it over there, will you?
Petra? Petra is one of the cases I wanted to talk to you about. I think she's very run down and that ankle's still not looking too good. But you won't come and see me. So I thought if you could use your influence.
I'm all right, honestly.
Oh, now we have a doctor. We may as well use him. Why don't you let him check you over just to make sure?
No, please. It'd just be a waste of time.
Well, I've plenty of time. And that ankle could get worse if it's not attended to.
If it does, I'll let you know.
All right, Robert, you don't have to see the doctor if you don't want to.
She's being very foolish.
Yes, I agree, but there's nothing we can do about it. Although it's very unusual. Most of the women have invented all sorts of exotic complaints just to see you. You're a very popular man.
What's the matter, love?
Nothing. I've just got a bit of a headache, that's all.
Hey, just a minute. This is me you're talking to, remember? Come on, come here. Okay, so it's a headache. So why don't you go and see the doctor? Maybe he could help.
I have seen him, just now in the governor's office.
Did you talk to him?
No. I was taking Mrs. Reynolds' tea and he was there. It was terrible. We just stood and stared at each other. I wish you hadn't told him, Bea.
I didn't tell him to cause trouble. I told him because he loves you and he has a right to know. Oh, can't you lean on him just a little?
I can't.
Most women would give their right arm to have what you've got. A bloke who really loves them and wants to be around when the going gets rough.
I just can't face him anymore. I feel so, I don't know, dirty, I suppose.
But it wasn't your fault. None of it was. You had a pretty rough time with your father. But don't let it ruin your whole life.
It's not just that. I'll never forget how I felt the first time he raped me. I wouldn't wish that on anyone. But I let it happen to Emma. I should have realized he wouldn't leave her alone. I let him rape my little sister. If I'd spoken up before, it wouldn't have happened. How can I face Scott now when he knows all that about me?
Because he loves you and he wants to help you. No one's blaming you. Least of all, Scott.
I blame myself. She was a sweet little girl, Bea. Now her life's ruined.
Well, if you feel like that, get out there and help her. Because she needs you now more than ever, but out there, not stuck in here. You know, good to anyone stuck in here, don't you understand?
What are you doing here, Bea?
Oh, I'm on my way, Mrs. M.
Well, not before you see Mr. Askin. He's in the governor's office.
Askin, who's he?
A solicitor, I believe.
Think about what I said. It does make sense.
Hello, love. How are you feeling?
I brought you this. Thought it might cheer you up.
Well, Wally sends his love. He wanted to come in and see, but they wouldn't let him.
I lost our baby.
Don't think about that now, love.
I have to, Kev. I killed him.
No. It was an accident. You couldn't help it.
If I hadn't taken them pills, it wouldn't have happened. You're right, Kev. I said I'd harm a baby, and I did. Everything I do turns out wrong. I've been so scared lately. That's why I kept taking the pills. I tried to stop, but I just couldn't. Things got worse and worse and...
I know that, love. But it seems to me that the only thing that you did wrong was not to talk to somebody about it. There are plenty of people that would have helped you. Me, Kevin.
It's too late for that now.
No, it's not. I want to start again.
How can we, Kev? It'll all just happen again.
Oh, yeah, of course it will. If you let it. On the other hand, you could go to the drug rehabilitation center and get some help. Well, it's up to you, honey. And you have a choice. You can go back to living the way you were, or you can build a new future for yourself and Kevin. I know what I'd do.
Give me another chance, Kev. Please.
He must be kidding.
No, Mrs. Smith, it's all in the will.
Where on earth would Mum get $20,000?
Well, she did have an insurance policy. She left half to her granddaughter and half to the women here.
That's incredible.
She certainly is very generous.
Yes, I didn't know Mrs. Brooks, but she must have felt pretty deeply about the women here.
Yes, she did. Even the ones who didn't deserve it. Did she say how she wanted us to use it? I mean, some of the women have started fighting over it already, and they think it's only 2,000. You can imagine what's going to happen now.
Well, the will simply stipulates it must be used by the women collectively for something they will all benefit from.
Oh, good. That should cut some of the hassles at least. I wouldn't like to see Mum's money wasted.
I'm glad to hear you say that, Mrs. Smith, because one of the conditions of the legacy was that you approve of anything decided on. In other words, you hold the purse strings.
Oh, Auntie Joan, I was hoping to see you. Find my little drug supply?
Maybe I did.
I see. In other words, you didn't. I didn't think you would.
Look, why don't you call the whole deal off? Oh, I can bring things in to you. But what good's that going to be to you? You see, these women won't take too kindly to you trading with me. You'll be able to buy some of them off, but not Smith. Maybe you found that out already.
Oh, you're quite right, Auntie Joan. I've changed my plans. I don't want goodies anymore. I want out, and you're going to set it up for me.
So that's it, ladies. It's up to us to decide what to do with the money.
God, pity Mum didn't have time to spend some of that dough on herself, though.
Yeah, well, look, seeing she has given it to us, like Bea said, what do we do with it?
Well, we could ask for a few improvements around here. A new library would be nice.
Oh, pull yourself together. There's enough flaming books around here as it is. What we do need is something that's going to bring us in some more money.
That sounds pretty good, Maxine. Like what?
I don't bloody well know, do I?
How about a racehorse of really fast filly?
I thought you would have lost enough money on the ponies over the years.
Yeah, but that'd give me a chance to get some of it back, wouldn't it?
Or how about a swimming pool? You could be nice and healthy then.
Hey, that's not a bad idea.
No, that's all right for you young ones, but an old-timer like me, God, me ticker wouldn't stand up to it. But a racehorse!
Yeah, well, what do you reckon, B?
I reckon we should form a committee. Write down our suggestions, and the committee can discuss them.
Right, and then they can make the final decision.
Well, you're the educated one around here. You want to be on it?
All right.
But you got to be on the committee, B. Then you can pay particular attention to your old mate.
I'm so glad you've got here. I tried to phone you at Wentworth, but you'd already left.
Well, what's wrong?
It's Emma. She's gone.
Gone? What do you mean, gone? Now, look, calm down and tell me what's happened.
She didn't come home from school. First, I thought she'd gone to a friend's place, but then when it got late, I started worrying.
Go on.
I went upstairs to her room. She'd packed a bag, left this note. I don't understand what it means. Why did she say that she couldn't talk to anyone else about her father?
I don't know.
And that last bit. I don't want to break my promise to Petra, but I can't stand it anymore. What did she promise Petra?
I'm not sure. Have you rung the police?
No. I thought I'd wait till you came.
We better not waste any more time. We better get on to them straight away.
Oh, hello, Auntie Joan.
If you want to get out of here, just shut up and listen.
That was quick. You got it worked out already. Good. What is it?
Not so fast. I want to know where those drugs are hidden.
I'm not that dumb. When I'm out and far away, I'll give you a ring.
Where are you going?
Queensland sounds nice.
Then you'd better ring, Lucy. Otherwise, I just might be tempted to tell the authorities where you are.
I don't think you'll do that, Auntie Joan. I'd have a few things to tell them myself. Okay, when's it happening?
Tomorrow, in the morning.
Good.
I'll call you to help load the laundry at the loading bay.
What happens then?
You'll find out when you get there.
I have to know.
You just make sure that you're on laundry duty tomorrow. Then do as I say. And that is all you need to know.
Paul? Paul?
Hello.
What on earth is this?
Sorry if I startled you, but Paul let me in before he left for work.
I can see you've been busy.
Well, I hope you don't mind, but my oven's so lousy, I figured if I cooked you a meal, you might let me stay and share it.
Of course I don't mind. I'm so tired, I thought it was going to be lettuce and cold meat again tonight.
Sit down. Make yourself at home.
This is wonderful.
I'll remove my penny. Things have been rough lately, haven't they?
Yes. Sometimes I wonder why I took on the job in the first place.
Oh, well, I think it's because you're a caring person. And you're also damn good at it.
Thanks.
Well, eat up. It'll taste lousy if you let it get cold. I'll get us a bottle of wine.
Well, well, your girlfriend gone off duty, has she?
Decided to take your advice and forget all that. It's not worth it.
Very healthy decision.
Do you reckon there'd be a chance of some work in the laundry?
No, haven't you changed your tune?
Gets pretty boring sitting in that cell all day. What do you reckon?
I don't see why not. See a screw in charge in the morning.
Well,
does the laundry van come tomorrow?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, thought so. Lovely.
What are you up to?
Nothing.
You're planning to nick off, aren't you?
What? Of course not.
Well, you're not the type to work if you don't have to. You better tell me. Otherwise, I might have to ask the other women what they think.
All right, I've got a plan.
Yeah, but if you go and buy a racehorse that can't run, then you've done your dough and you're left with this horse you have to feed.
Get it. Nobody takes any notes of me anyway.
That's not a bad idea.
Hey, yeah. Shall we have got a few more?
Beauty, you've got yourself a partner.
What? I can't take you.
Oh, you'll take me. Otherwise, I'll make sure you don't get out either. Well, am I in?
All right, you're in.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.